Autodesk NetFabb is a powerful tool that can be used to repair .stl files that have errors in them. As a student, you have access to this for free. You type into Google NetFabb student download, the first link should be able to take you to set up an account. If you use your Sydney University email account, you should be able to access this program for free. Within NetFabb, you want to go File, Add Part, and choose the files you want to add. When I open this set of stairs, I get this quality error. It looks like there's something wrong with these stairs. I could click Automatic Part Repair, and it will repair the part automatically. I'm going to show us what's wrong with these stairs. If I add the part, I can see that I have some inverse-oriented triangles. So everything should be yellow, but here it looks like I'm looking at the back face. And it looks like there's a big hole here with that I can see through. So I want to patch that hole and have this fixed up. If I right-click on it and I go Prepare, Repair Part, it shows me here that I have border edges 22, inverse oriented 6, and some holes in the file. That's all highlighted in the diagram. If I run the repair script, I have a choice between a default, a simple, and an extended. I'm going to go for the extended repair. When I execute that, it looks like it's fixed up all these holes and inverse oriented surfaces and border edges. We now have 0, 0, 0, and so that's looking good. I'm going to apply that repair, remove the old part, right click, and now export that new part as a .stl, and it's saving it now with the extension repaired. Hit OK, and we now have a repaired part saved. NetFabb can also be really useful for separating parts in one STL into multiple STLs. For example, if I import this file, all gears, I see it's one file but with three parts in it. This part's floating off the platform, and I think this part should be printed 90 degrees to sit on the platform. I also seem to have a problem here where a surface is missing, and it looks like maybe some oriented surfaces are the wrong way around. If I preview this and go preview, you can see that it's going to need to generate some support before my part is actually made. And the other problem is that it's filled in the hole in the center here. And there should be a hole in there. So to fix this, I'm going to go to NetFabb, File, Add Part, the file, All Gears, Open. You can see here there's the problem with the file. If I tick on Automatic Part Repair, Extended Repair, that should fix it. I'm going to add the part, and yes, this part hole has now been fixed. I also want to right click on it and go Modify, Split Shells into Parts, remove the old part, yes. I now have three separate files which are now underneath here, 1, 2, 3, and I can export those three separate files by clicking Shift, select 2, select 3, right clicking, and export part as an STL. Here, instead of choosing all into one file, I can choose original part name with loading list. Now that'll be called All Gears with Shell 1, 2, and 3. Click OK. And now, when I go into Cura, I can open up those new files. That one, open. I no longer need this part, so I'm going to delete that. And you can see that it's automatically put flat on the platform. This one here, I'm going to want to rotate that one and lay it flat. I'm going to go Edit, Arrange All Models, and that will put the parts nicely on the platform. You want to avoid having parts a long way from the center, because it's colder in the corner here, and it's more likely to come off the platform. Now, when I slice it and preview, it looks like my hole is fixed here, and that should be a successful print.